Hello, I'm Graham McTavish. My day job is as an actor, and you may know me from some shows like Outlander and House of the Dragon and The Witcher, a few things like that. But today, I am the tartan ambassador for this fabulous exhibition at the V&A in Dundee. And I invite you to join me as I see it for the first time, and it's going to be a treat! Okay, this is my first look at the exhibition, so you're joining me on that, and I think we're in for a treat, so let's see what it is. This week, or last week, they found the oldest piece of tartan. Of course they have it.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, I'm not going to swear. To think that this was worn by somebody probably around 500 years ago. 500 years ago, around the time of Mary, Queen of Scots, that person would have been walking around at that. Imagine what that piece of cloth has seen. I mean, I'm kind of overwhelmed, actually. I mean, I've only just walked into one room. It's the craftsmanship. Who couldn't love tartan? I mean, seriously, who couldn't love it? Wow. It's such a worldwide phenomenon. You know, from something that was worn, as we saw in that ancient little bit of cloth there, as just a garment to keep you warm, to camouflage you. This is, in fact, my costume from Outland. Yes, amazing, amazing to see. We didn't really see it so much in the show. I genuinely wore it in private. Note how it was worn above, quite a long way above the knee. Not the look I prefer to go for, really.
McTavish.
What?
Yeah,
no.
That was my appointment.
Oh my God. So, Isabella McTavish got married in this dress? How random is that? My God. That's pretty incredible. I mean, if there are any more McTavishes in this exhibition, I'm going to be very, very suspicious. Oh, check out this barn. Look at that. You wouldn't miss him on a dark night, would you? Good God. It's like a homing beacon. Imagine his wife. Oh, you're not going to wear that. Or no.
Well,
obviously, the most important part of the exhibition. My turn. I mean, everything else looks okay. But really, when you look at this. No, I wore this. I wore this in many kilts. 1745. And look, I mean, the colours are still so vibrant. And again, I always think about the people. The people who were in these. Dougal MacKenzie would, I think he'd be very proud, actually. Yeah. He'd probably drink too much at the party, though. And then things would get very, very awkward. Probably bother a few of the guests. Maybe a punch-up.
Not the plan for
you then. No, that's not happening. It's not happening. But it's only 9 o'clock in the morning. There's a whatever it's called, an Xbox or something. I've never played video games even though I've done quite a few of them. Yeah, I mean, a tight fit.
See, that looks like Jackie Stewart's racing helmet. I grew up with him he was my favorite. I thought I recognized this. This is the British Caledonian cabin crew uniform. My father flew for British Caledonian, and he was actually chosen because of our extraordinarily Scottish name to be the sort of face of British Caledonian at one time. Alexander McTavish was my father's name, and this is what his crew used to wear. All I can say is, please come, because this is a unique opportunity to see all of this fabulous stuff in one place in one of the most beautifully designed buildings in Europe, let alone Britain. So, if you're lucky enough to come here, it will be a rare privilege, so.